I'm Carson Kahn, co-founder and chief product officer here at Spindle. We are the only AI-native business analytics platform for enterprise strategic finance and scenario analysis, and I'm thrilled to share what we're building with you today. To start, let's analyze this custom table of KPIs by segment for Business Unit 3 by using Spindle's AI agent to generate scenarios in which we can increase our new customer ARR targets by 11% in the subsequent quarters. For some analysts, this would take hours or days, but Spindle's AI agent has produced a verifiable solution in seconds. I'd like to tweak it so that we don't change the forecast in the second half of the year, only juice our top performing segments, and don't change so many of our global assumptions. Spindle's AI agent verifiably obeys my instructions, and we're ready to save this generated scenario to our model. We can also add some more detail to this scenario by breaking down one of our segments into some subsegments, let's say geographic subsegments with appropriately forecasted values. I'll save it to my model, tweak the assumptions a little bit, add a scenario I generated before, and we're ready to compare our scenarios in multiple dimensions across various KPIs of our business. What's amazing about Spindle AI, though, is that the agent can help you generate, compare, analyze, understand, and share hundreds or thousands of scenarios that capture the nuances of how your business might evolve, not just two or three. Let's use Spindle's platform in full, starting from row-level data, to figure out how we might do this. To begin, we need to import some data, in this case from Salesforce Finance Cloud. I've already got about 120,000 rows of bookings and product bookings information in here, so we'll just add account information, and then materialize this table. The summary table is now something we can add other dimensions of our data to, for instance, geo, product category, and seat band. Whoops, seat band is not in the model yet, so we need to create a custom field. No problem. We'll ask the AI agent to help us write a query to the database. Save the custom field, tag our data accordingly, and add it to our table. Excellent. This is looking pretty close to analysis for me. Rather than passing it off to an analyst, how about we give it to Spindle's AI agent and see what it comes up with first? Entering analysis mode, we could simulate how changes in 3 to 5 key drivers impact margins or forecast the impact of on 2 to 3 KPIs of changes in a product mix. Perhaps we'll do that one by forecasting the impact on revenue of customers without purchases in our Sentinel product line buying more products in that product line. Spindle's AI agent is now going to reason about our data, the structure, the calculations, the constraints, and our business needs to come up with an analytical plan we can audit and verify. This looks pretty good to me, so let's go ahead and run it. Excellent. Spindle's AI agent has generated a revenue mix or channel mix shift analysis for me, and even compared for me some of the scenarios it found most promising. This looks just about ready to hand off to an agent on my team for further analysis. Let's see what Jessica came up with. It looks like Jessica added a couple new forecasting methods to the AI agent's analysis. She's considering a forecast scope of all quarters and last 12 months, but she's using the same shift rate that the AI agent was using, a 50%. I think we should explore a fuller scenario landscape, so let's use a multi-valued assumption of 10% to, say, 60%. Before we can explore the implications of this multi-valued assumption, we need to figure out which one of these forecasting methods we should probably be using. Backtesting would be a good solution, so let's do that. We simply put product category on context, seat band on context, forecast scope on context, and switch from forecast mode into backtest error mode. Perfect. The scenario landscape we've generated here is like a unique barcode for this forecast of our business. And if we compare the backtest values across the scenario landscape, it's pretty clear to me that last 12 months has much less backtest error than all quarters. So let's go with that. We're now ready to look at the full scenario landscape again, including our multi-valued assumption. Perhaps we shouldn't be using the 50% assumption. It looks to me like something closer to 30% is more realistic based on our data, so we'll save that. Next, we want to pick a scenario to focus on. Of course, I'm not willing to sacrifice very many accounts, so let's restrict this to the positive domain. Also, I'd like my MRR to at least stay the same or perhaps increase if customers are going to be shifting to new products. And I'm not willing to sacrifice seat count too much because it's critical to our pricing and packaging model. We've now isolated these thousands of AI-generated scenarios down to just a few. And by comparing them, I can see Sentinel Core is clearly a more favorable direction of shift for our business. So we'll save that as well. We can confirm that this is a desirable scenario because the number of accounts has neither increased nor decreased at all. Our seat count has decreased only slightly, but our MRR, well, it's up 11%, just like the AI-generated analysis we ran in the first part of this video. Now, I'm ready to copy this data, share it out in my report to the rest of the team, include the AI's own analysis here, and send this to some decision makers on the product marketing team, sales finance team, and others who can help us kick this new plan into action. Spindle is amazing, both as a general purpose AI agent for strategic finance and for use cases like revenue mix shift, pricing and packaging, bundling strategy, margin optimization and cost structure optimization, long range planning, go-to-market strategy, including marketing pipeline and sales coverage, and even capital structuring and capital replanning. Whatever you use it for, we're excited to hear about it. And thank you so much for learning about Spindle AI.